JT here with another YouTube or otherwise video. This one's entitled Liars and False Prophets, Agendas to Both Damn and Deceive. And this is part one, the Delphi Technique and World Scripts for Consensus. Delphi Techniques are for generating false consensus, okay? If you go back and look at my video on Delphi techniques, you'll understand how they use various methods and machinations to achieve their agendas, okay? And they're all pre-planned, and the outcomes are inevitable based upon their methodology. Now, based upon desire, opinion, or belief, scientists are commissioned or granted funds to do particular studies that can be used as a basis for propagating these globalist agendas. These are things one must understand. Published results from inadequate studies which they use, and those data they use, are placed by means of editorial and or financial control over content in major journals, newspaper, or public media. Such efforts make parallel constructions in order that they might reinforce the fear and trauma programs by redundant and repeated pounding in of indoctrinations. This mainstream media is worldwide. They purvey and promulgate the results and or agendas without regard to verification or proper investigation of claims made by their paid or funded scientists. See the previous parts, who are obviously part of the globalist institutions, for example, the IPCC, which is an internal UN NGO organization. Over time, increasing and converging awareness is made in the public by repetition through publicity, by and through the mainstream media, and it is achieved, okay? This is done through multiple outlets of disinformation and misinformation, which they need to purvey. Eventually, they have success, such as what they have established pretty much with their so-called climate agenda. What it develops is a worldwide indoctrination, and it is accepted nearly universally, being reinforced by social psychology and groupthink methods, which I outline and discuss in many of my videos. At the same time, deniers or skeptics, anyone who questions their agenda, their data, their premises, or anything, are shamed and ostracized. And that's pretty much what's going on. That's a Delphi technique for a general or global consensus, collective groupthink, hive-minded programming. Do you understand? Now, they use the problem-reaction-solution, or Hegelian dialectic, in most cases. For example, the problem with climate lie, is presented to us that we're all going to die, oh no! And the reaction, which is modeled, guided, and or programmed by media, is fear and trauma. This is a form of programming. This is how they get us to be programmed, is through fear and trauma, which limits, reduces, or eliminates rational discussion or rational thought or questioning whatever they say. This is a good example of this is the whole agenda that was behind and all the machinations involved in, for example, 911. Now, you know, there was three buildings that went down in that day, and one of them wasn't even hit by an airplane. So, ostensibly it was pulled, but however, how could it be pulled without any forethought or setup or preparation? It doesn't happen while there's fires in the building. They don't go in and put in demolition charges in a few hours. Okay, it just doesn't happen. It doesn't make any sense. It's crazy. It's insane. But we aren't supposed to think about it. Okay, you're not supposed to discuss it. You're not supposed to question. Okay. So fear and trauma programming is basically how they do this, and the reaction is guided by what is presented in the media, and the in fact, using our example of 911, you know, the fact that we were being attacked by some terrorists, yeah, right, anyway. In addition to this fear and trauma programming, anyone going against it, questioning it, or going against the narrative of the collective group think is guilt or fear of retribution or shaming or whatever. Anyway, because we were told the problem is the world is ending, or some part of our world or our beliefs or whatever is under attack, and so we have to fear and be afraid, you know. And by the way, somehow or another, it's always going to be your fault. They're going to blame you. Okay, I don't want to get too carried away with that. Now, the third part is the solution. And in this case, unilateral choices usually have no alternatives or explanations why their particular solutions can or will work or solve the problem at hand they present. But inevitably, it's going to be surrendering your sovereignty, and the result is you pay and obey, okay, up in the right-hand corner. They will appoint experts and the priest class as de facto rulers and arbitrators of whatever solution that they have. They will save us from ourselves and for a price and for a loss of sovereignty. Now, an example of the so-called expert would be, in the case of climate change, is a liar, like Mr. Gore, okay, who benefits directly and financially from the agenda, okay. And the other character involved is the UN and the Pope. And they both gain power and control. Okay. And so the end result is global governance and kowtowing to liars who want to take your money. So you are robbed and your power is taken away. Enter the New World Order. Okay. The climate deception is a generation of false prophecies and programming. These false prophets are proven liars. Surely there are people who still remember these past dire predictions as I do, and the diabolical agenda is being promoted by traitorous, deceiving media. This is a short video. Actually, it's not short. Okay, here's an article taken from CEI.org, blog, wrong answer to you spelled eco-apocalyptic predictions, and there's the site, and the article, and the purpose of this clip is to show that not only have we been programmed like
it's 3 o'clock.
For the last generation or so, but also to show how they build their consensus by inundation and repetition, and the evil people who are behind this stuff and what they really think, okay? And now, the earlier articles, like from the 60s and 70s, with Paul Ehrlich and Eric Holdren and such characters show and reveal what they're really up to, although in these later ones and a more modern era stuff, they're not showing it. They're just purveying the lie, okay? Anyway, so if you want more information, go to this article and whatever. Modern doomsayers have been predicting climate and environmental disasters since the 60s. They continue to do so today. While such predictions have been and continue to be enthusiastically reported by media, eager for sensational headlines, and from promoting the agenda, by the way, the failures are typically not revisited. In other words, they don't recant or decant. They're errors. Okay. And I'm going to try to go through this pretty quickly. This is from 1967, Salt Lake City Tribune. Dire famine forecast. Now, and I want to emphasize that there are converging themes within all of these articles, which is climate and famine and overpopulation, okay? Those are all intrinsically and inherently tied together in the sustainability complex of the UN, okay? Okay. Now, this one in particular is important because it's from a Stanford University biologist said Thursday that this Paul Ehrlich said the time of famines is upon us, most will be at its worst and most disastrous by 1975. Okay, this is the same kind of claptrap that was proposed by a certain Al Gore, not too long ago in 2006. He said basically, like ICAP's going to be gone and by 2013, well, that's still there. But here I want you to know that he said the population of the United States is already too big that birth control may have to be accomplished by making it involuntary and by putting sterilizing agents into staple foods and drinking water, and that the Roman Catholic Church should be pressured into going along with such measures of population control. Notice the keys in there. You've got the church, or the beast, rider, the harlot, involved with the RCC, Roman Catholic Church. You've got depopulation, you've got involuntary sterilizing agents in the food and the water. Toxins and poison.
He says
experts keep saying the world food supply will have to be tripled to feed the 6 or 7 billion people they expect to be living in 2000. Which is, according to him, totally impossible in practice. Okay. Now this is the real agenda, and this is what they really want to do. And they're telling us in the newspaper back in the 60s. Okay. Now, Sunday New York Times, August 10, 69, full pollution, see lack of time. Again, Paul Ehrlich, or Ehrlich, I'm not sure. We must realize that unless we're extremely lucky, everyone will disappear in a cloud of blue steam in 20 years. Okay. These are false prophets, alright? They're purveying false science, and they're purveying it based upon what? Who knows? But we're being, or have been, indoctrinated and inundated, pounded in since the late 60s, throughout my entire life. With fear and trauma.
Apocalyptic, eco-apocalyptic. Along the same line. Here, air pollution may obliterate the sun and cause a new ice age, okay? The demands for cooling water will boil dry the entire flow of the rivers and streams of continental USA. You know, here's Dr. Ehrlich again, outspoken ecologist. See, you know, you've got to get his face in there. Come on. You know. And look at this. Ehrlich predicts that the oceans will be as dead as Lake Erie in less than a decade. And this was in 1970, okay? That was a false prediction. That was false prophecy. The DDT in our fatty tissues has reached levels high enough to cause brain damage and cirrhosis of the liver. Good point, Mr. Ehrlich. This is made, DDT was made, and then blown all over the place until it did present a real threat to not only humanity, but also the various ecosystems involved. And thankfully, we got rid of that and outlawed it.
Okay. Now we have glyphosate.
Who is the one polluting?
Atrazine.
Who were the big chem pushers of DDT who said it was safe? Okay? Think about that. Once you profit from all of these toxics and poisons and all that, are the ones who are killing us. Okay? Extension with University of California will present outspoken author of the population bomb, okay? That was Dr. Ehrlich, the population bomb. Think about it. That's a depopulation program. That's what they want to do, is depopulate. They want to kill us all. They want to make us have involuntarily eating and drinking sterilizing agents. And do you think that's not what we're doing right now? Okay, again, next 50 years, small particles would screen out much of the sunlight and sustained over a few years. A decrease would trigger an ice age. Okay. And some claptrap from a Brown University doctor. New ice age is coming fast. Okay. And time, another ice age coming. Yeah. Telltale signs everywhere, from the unexpected persistence and thickness of pack ice. Wait a minute. Isn't that just the opposite of what Mr. Gore was pushing? Okay. And then there was an ozone depletion scare back in the... Kills life in waves. But then later, the U.S. government program formed a study isodrine actually concluded it's not a crisis. Hey, what do you know? 1978, no end in sight to a 30-year cooling trend. Okay, now, that's 1978. It's cooling. Okay, I'm not going to go through all this. More droughts, likely expert. The expert class, the scientism priest class, is telling everybody that climate simulations indicate a tendency for an increase of heat wave drought situations in the southeast and midwest.
Wait. But the real simulations?
The last really dry year was 1988, and recent years have been record wet. Okay. And here's their predictions versus the actual. It looks like there's quite a bit of rain up in there. So, okay. Okay, prepare for long, hot summers. Now,
1988,
they were warning that Washington, D.C. would go from 35 days a year over 90 degrees to 85 days a year. Okay, so it's starting to warm up now all of a sudden. Well, here was this forecast, and what do you know? It's actually going down, number of days. Okay, rising seas to obliterate nations. Now, all of a sudden, it's gone from freezing to warming. Okay, and now they're saying Maldives completely underwater in 30 years, and rising seas to obliterate nations. But, and hey, somewhere along the lines there, they flipped their switch. Okay, what happened? Jim Henson, a scientist in 1988, predicted the greenhouse effect before Congress. I went over the window. If what you're saying about greenhouse effect is true, is anything going to look different down there in 20 years? And he replied that the West Side Highway, which runs along the Hudson River in New York, will be underwater. You have signs in restaurants saying water by request only. When will this happen? Within 20 or 30 years? Okay. And that was about 20 or 30 years ago. Hey, what do you know? It didn't happen. Here's the climate model and the failure to show what they predicted. This is the so-called hockey stick model from the IPCC, which is basically an NGO / subsidiary of the UN, whatever. Well, you can see that the actual observations were nothing like the predicted scare tactic. Here's one, 2000, children won't even know snow is disappearing from our lives. Children won't even know what snow is. This is warming, of course. Okay. Children aren't going to know what snow is. All right. So somewhere around there in the late 80s, it turned from ice age to burning in hell. Okay. And according to this, Britain is going to have a Siberian climate. What? That kind of goes opposite. Climate change will, Pentagon tells Bush, climate change will destroy us. Is the scientism worshipped god of CGI and magic. Okay. They say we're toast, people. Said 5 to 10 years now, this was in 2008. In 5 to 10 years, the Arctic will be free of ice in the summer. Okay. 20 years later, we recognize him as a climate prophet.
We're talking about Gore here.
Now, here, 10 years ago, Al Gore predicted that the North Polar ice cap would be gone. Inconveniently, the truth is, it's still there. In fact, it's actually thicker and bigger and larger than it was. It has increased over and above. Also pushing this so that they can add some star power to the brainwash. Okay. For example, 2009, Prince Charles says we only got 8 years to save the planet. 9 to 6 months. There's that yo-yo. Who we find that's Prince Charles. Okay, I'm not sure. Is that the guy who was accused of being a pedo? No. Okay, 2009, UK Prime Minister says 50 days to save the planet. 50 days! 50 days! Fewer than 50 days. Wow, okay. And there's Gore with another, with his buddy from the, one of these radical climate meetings and stuff. Arctic is ice-free Arctic in 2 years from methane melting.
They just keep coming up with more and more agendas.
Somewhat more disturbing than the other one. Navy, so you got the Navy in on it, you got NASA in on it, you got politicians in on it, you got monarchs and so-called elites, 500 days. French Foreign Minister, well, he must be an expert, 500 days to avoid climate chaos, 2014. Climate chaos, again. And so on and so on. So, well, the earliest mentions here, back in the 60s and 70s, they noted that their plans and in their white papers and all that kind of stuff, we're talking about involuntary sterilizing, they're going to put your food in your water, and that the Roman Catholic Church, the harlot riding the beast, must be frauded into going along with it.
No problem. He's a willing participant.
And all of these so-called elites, organizations, and NGOs, and globalist entities are all in agreement.
So we see that false prophets and media hacks are proven liars, and their agenda goes on and on. Surely there are people who still remember these dire predictions. Like I do. The ultimate goal is global rule, but many sub-goals are achieved as well. They tax and regulate and usurp control of industries by global rules and policy, not necessarily law. which is a loss of sovereign control by governments, which, by the way, are also simply corporations. Demonizing of fossil fuels, so-called, which is the only viable energy sources that we have. For example, see my videos on divestiture scams and the fossil fuels series in my Whoppers playlist. Collapsed economies are inevitable due to increased taxes and regulations and sanctions against using energy, which is what drives all economies. Massive profits are made by and through carbon trade scams, and these are by the bigs, the elites themselves, who are running all these agenda. They're the ones who actually do pollute and are contribute to the problem, which they are stating. There's no real change in extant industry, except some people get more profits. And there's globalist control in the replacement energy sources. They get in on the bottom floor, access to alternative tech and industry production and or sales are made, and then they are given tax credits and incentives and so on. Think of Obama regime and his failed solar industry connection with Solyndra, and I think we ended up giving them like pretty close to $1 billion, and then they went bankrupt. Hey, what do you know? Graft and corruption, anyone? Their goal is to rob the poor and enrich the rich. None of the foregoing events or repercussions benefit the poor or the average population. But the rich get richer and gain power through usurping control through their corporate entities and the government. Powerful corporations further usurp government control through lobbying, which are actually bribery systems. This is mammon worship. It's unfair to the average person for them to be taking over government. And it's fascist. Okay. Nations lose sovereign control of energy and utilities, which are needed for both basic subsistence and survival, especially lower income people, the working man and woman. Nations and peoples become subordinate to a global collective as a result of all these so-called agreements, which are not necessarily going into law, but they are adopted, and it is becomes the policy of the various entities involved. City, state, county, federal, and national, whatever. Your power goes to unelected officials who are non-responsive to the people or their needs or desires. This also promotes false gods, this whole system, and false prophets, and false religion. For example, Scientism, giving the Pope and the Roman Catholic Church more power, the ecumenical harlot, religion, Gaia worship in the form of saving the earth and Mother Nature,